Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre, and this is 17th audio for you. One thing you have to note that in 11th and 12th standard mathematics that you are going to do, trigonometry will play a very important role. It may be derivative, it may be integration, it may be limits, continuity, or any chapter you take from these 2 years, you have to have a sound knowledge of trigonometry. And this study of trigonometry starts with angle, okay, and how the angles are measured. So it is angle that you are going to study is a directed angle. What is this directed angle? Let ray OA, O is generally origin. Let ray OA rotate around O and reach the position of the ray OB. Then the directed angle AOB is an ordered pair of rays, ray OA, ray OB. Together with the amount of rotation of the ray OA to attain the position of ray OB. So this ray OA which rotates is called initial arm, and the ray OB is called terminal arm of that directed angle AOB. Now the convention is, if this rotation of the ray OA is in anti-clockwise direction, then the angle is called positive angle. And if the ray OA takes the clockwise direction, then the angle so formed is the negative angle. So, angle AOB is not angle BOA. Okay, now different types of the angles. First is zero angle. See, if the directed angle AOB, the rays OA and OB are same, that is amount of rotation is zero, then we call that angle as zero angle. Then what is straight angle? If the directed angle AOB, the initial arm, that is ray OA, and the terminal arm, ray OB, are opposite rays. Okay, opposite rays. Then it is a straight angle. What is measure of straight angle? It is 180 degrees or minus 180 degrees. The measure of zero angle is naturally 0 degrees. Whole angle. If for a directed angle AOB, the initial arm, that is ray OA, after completing one complete rotation in the anti-clockwise direction, coincides with initial position, then we get whole angle. What is the measure of whole angle? 360 degrees. Okay, and if for any directed angle AOB, the initial arm, that is ray OA, rotates about O in anti-clockwise direction and takes any position before coinciding the ray OA again, then we get directed angle whose measure lies between 0 degrees and 360 degrees. Remember, when that rotation completes, rotation of the initial arm completes full rotation and again comes back to ray OA, then it is 360 degrees. But when you take angles of degrees 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 120 degrees, 240 degrees, these are all angles which are not zero angle, also they are not full angle. So their measure lies between 0 degrees and 360 degrees. Now there is something called coterminal angles. See, the word co means common, common terminal arm. Before that, we should know what is meant by standard angle. See, in XY plane, origin is considered as a standard point, and positive direction of x-axis is the standard direction. So if your angle is such that said initial arm is along positive direction of x-axis and its initial vertex, that means vertex of that angle is at origin. Vertex is at origin and initial arm is, that is ray OA, lies along positive direction of x-axis. Then that angle is said to be standard angle. That is a standard angle. Now two directed angles, they are called coterminal angles. If their terminal arms are same but the measures are different. For example, if you take angle of degrees 30, now every time whenever we will talk about angle, it is a standard angle. So if that angle is of degree 30 degrees, and so take one angle, say having degrees, measure is 30 degrees, and another angle whose measure is 390 degrees. Now what is 390? What will be that angle? It will be full complete rotation and plus 30 degrees. Or if you take another angle whose measure is minus 330 degrees. Minus means it will be clockwise rotation. It will go and again come back to the first quadrant. Again the same arm of degree 30. It means these three angles that I have talked about, 30 degrees, 390 degrees, minus 330 degrees, or also you can take two complete rotations, 720 and plus 30, 750 degrees. These are all angles of different measures, but their initial and terminal arm is same. Such angles are called coterminal angles. What is coterminal angle? Two or more angles having different measures but having same initial and terminal arm. Next is angle in a quadrant. So if the terminal arm of the angle lies in one of the four quadrants, suppose I take angle of 30 degrees, its terminal arm will be in first quadrant. If you take angle of 120 degrees, terminal arm will be in second quadrant. Such angles are called angles in quadrant. And if you take angles of 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, 450 degrees, you can see easily that their terminal arm lies on one of the coordinate axes, maybe positive direction of x-axis or positive direction of y-axis, negative direction of y-axis, etc. Such angles are called quadrantal angles. Now always you are using degree measure. So we have to, it is not the only measure by which angles are measured. So we must study system of measurement of angles. There are two systems. One is sexagesimal system, which is also known as a degree measure. And another is circular system, which is also called as a radian measure. Okay, what is done in degree measure? This is a common unit of measurement of angles, which is in which 1 degree means 1 upon 360th part of one complete rotation in anti-clockwise direction. 1 degree is denoted by 1 raised to 0, like that. 1 degree is further divided into 60 equal parts, and each part is called 1 minute. Now if you draw angle of 1 minute, it cannot be seen by, or you cannot draw it by using usual measurement equipments. So it is, what is done is 1 degree is further divided into 60 parts, and each part is called 1 minute, and this 1 minute is also further divided into 60 equal parts, and each part is called 1 second. So a complete rotation in anticlockwise direction is 360 degrees, 1/360th part, 1/360th part of one complete rotation in anticlockwise direction is 1 degree. This 1 degree is 60 minutes and 1 minute is 60 seconds. So this is what you should know about degree measure. Next is a circular system. It's a radian measure. What is done here is, you should know what is definition of 1 radian. 1 radian is the measure of an angle subtended at the center of the circle by an arc of a circle, the length of the arc being equal to the radius of the circle. It means, if you have a circle whose radius is 5 centimeters, then you take arc on the circle whose length is 5 centimeters. Suppose that arc is AB. What you do is join A and B to origin. The angle AOB will be 1 radian. System of measuring angles in which the measures of the angles are expressed in terms of radians is called circular system. So you should know two measures we have studied. One is degree measure, another is radian measure. What is the relation between these two? So we should know that 1 radian is same as 180 upon pi degrees. 1 radian is same as 180 upon pi degrees. And 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radians. So in short, you should remember pi is equal to 180 degrees. This is the relation. And that is why if you have to convert x degrees into radians, you will multiply x by pi by 180. Remember, if I want to convert x degrees to radians, I must multiply x by pi by 180. And if we want to do converse, that means degree I have to convert into radians, then I will, suppose it is x degrees, to make it into radians, I have to multiply it by x into pi by 180. So when you multiply by pi by 180, suppose example is 30 degrees, I want to convert it into radians, so 30 you will multiply by pi by 180, so it will be pi by 6. 30 degrees is pi by 6 radians. 90 degrees is pi by 2 radians. Remember, pi means 180. If it is, 60 degrees, multiply 60 by pi by 180. So it will become pi by 3, like that. Conversely, suppose you have given, 2 pi by 3 radians. I want to convert it into degrees. You will multiply by 2 pi by 3, you will multiply by 180 upon pi. So pi gets cancelled. And if you calculate it, 2 pi by 3 becomes 2 pi by 3 radians. It becomes 120 degrees. So this is the conversion between radians and degrees, degrees and radians, etc. More about this in the next audio. I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.